If you're looking to create a ticketing system where you can track the status of feature requests or any other kind of ticket that might be submitted externally, then you have come to the right place. In this video, I will be building that from scratch. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. One of our favorite tools in the no-code space is SmartSuite, and that is exactly what we're going to be breaking down here today as we build our own ticketing system inside of the SmartSuite platform. But before we get started, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. Automation is the key that's going to unlock so much power that no code has to offer. And if you haven't yet mastered the fundamentals, I've put together a nice training that will help you get over that finish line. Check out that free training at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration, and you will learn how to build no code automations to do that mundane, repetitive work in the background for you. And it doesn't matter what tool you're using, whether that's SmartSuite, Zapier, Make, whatever it is, all of these no code automations follow the same framework. So go ahead and grab that training. But for now, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen and start building our very own ticketing system from scratch. Now, two key things that we really want to be cautious of breaking out here are the people submitting the tickets and then also the ticket itself. Now, of course, one person or one organization might submit multiple tickets over time with us, so we need to be able to track them accordingly. And so because we are working with two separate data sets, the first thing we need to do is build those two applications inside of SmartSuite. So you see here, I'm in a brand new application, a brand new solution called Ticketing Solution. I've given it the ticket icon here, and I've got my first app, which has nothing done to it yet. So I'm gonna click into this app and I'm going to rename it. This will be my contacts. It could also be renamed to clients or accounts or something along those lines. The key takeaway here is that in this application, I'm storing information about the person who submits the ticket, and I'm going to trace that information throughout the rest of the solution. So I'm going to first go ahead and hide my setup fields here. These come in by default, so I'm going to clear them all out. This is not deleting them, it's just hiding them from this particular view. And now I can add in the information that I need for this particular account. So maybe I'll have something like the primary contact, and I'll use a full name field to categorize or store the information for this person. So I'll call this primary contact. I can denote here if I want to include other fields, but I'm good with the first and last name. And from here, I might also want to keep the primary email. So I'll add a new field. Let's select email here, and I'll rename this to be primary email. And again, add this field here. I can add a lot of other information. The key is that all of this information and data that I collect here relates to the account or the contact who is submitting that ticket. Lastly, I'm going to come into this title and I'm going to rename this, and I'll make this the account name. And I will not want it to be auto-generated. I will not care if it's unique or if there's an entry in the field, and I'll update this. Now, once that's all saved up, we can add our first account. So let's say we have an account on Acme and maybe I am the primary contact there. So I will go ahead and enter in my name here. And lastly, once I'm saved here, I will go over to email and get that set up as well. You get the idea. The core concept again is that we are storing the contact or account information. Now we are going to move over to our second application. And over here, this is where we're going to actually create the tickets. So I've added a new app. Now I'm going to rename this to tickets. And similarly to the previous application, the first thing I'm going to do is open up my fields to display, and I'm going to clear all of the stuff that's over there from before. I don't want those defaults in for now. And I'm going to set up certain things inside of my ticket. So I might have, let's say, a status of priority. So I will use a single select field here, find that from the list, and I will call this priority. And I can enter a few different options. I might have high priority, medium, and low. I can change the colors of these different options as well if I so choose, and I can reorder them inside of the app as well. Looks like I already had a field called priority, so I'll just call this priority star and add this field. Next, I might want to have a status that actually tracks this particular ticket itself. So let's go ahead and add a new field here. And again, I might add a single select, or if you saw earlier, I also have a status option. So let's go ahead and roll with status here. And since I already have a status field, I'll call this one status star as well, because I can't have two fields with the same name. So what is going to be the status options here? Well, I want to track how my team is doing in responding to the ticket that has come in. And so I might keep these very status that are present here, but these are just examples. And so if I didn't want this, I could of course make changes, reorder them, recolor them, etc. I'm happy with this. One thing I do want to do though is add a default field. I need to make sure that when a new ticket comes in, it's automatically assigned to the backlog status. That way my team knows that, hey, we need to pick this up so that we can start working with it. All right, once we're happy with this, we add this field as well. It'll take SmartSuite a moment to save it up, and we're good. Now, I need to build a linked relationship from my tickets to my contacts. This is how I'm gonna trace and know who submitted the actual open ticket. So let's go ahead and build that link. I have a linked record option here, and I need to make sure that I'm marking this to link to the right solution, in this case, ticketing solution. We see it written right here. That's a nice new addition. And also to the right application. So I need to find the contact inside of the ticketing solution. This is exactly right. And I can also bring in allow linking to multiple records or not. So if I only want a ticket to belong to one particular contact at a time, I need to toggle this off. Now, of course, this makes sense. Multiple organizations, multiple accounts are not going to submit the same ticket. So I want each ticket to have one and only one link to my contacts. I can also choose what information is visible inside of my fields. So over here, this is perfect. I want to keep the fields that I created, the account name, the primary contact, and the primary email is good for now, although we're going to be adding some extra stuff here. Let's go ahead and save that up. Now, when we're adding this linked relationship, this link to contacts, it's also true that we're building the opposite side of that link. So over here in contacts, if I look at fields to display, I'm going to find that I now have a link to tickets that did not previously exist. And this is because I just built that linked relationship. So if a ticket links to a contact, the contact must also link to a ticket. So now let's go ahead and imagine what kind of information we need on the ticket. So the priority and the status, these are internal fields that we're going to be working with. But when somebody submits a ticket, we need to categorize that and we need them to provide some information. So we will probably want to use a text area field for this. This is a large block of text where we can collect multiple sentences from somebody and allow them to submit that information. So I might want to rename this to be ticket question or ticket issue. And also, I will want to include a potential attachment field. So I might want people to submit screenshots along with their ticket issue if they found a bug or something like that. So let's go ahead and use the attachment field here. And I can simply call this attachments, or I could call it files, whatever I would like. Let's go ahead and add this field as well. And then lastly, you might also want to include the ability for people to post a bit of a screen share. Maybe you give them the option to create a URL so they can take a quick Loom video and showcase the issue they're having. Again, another way of them being able to capture the information that they need. So if you need that third field as well, you could include the URL option here, the link. Note that this is different from a link to another application, which is what we used here in our link to contacts. This is an actual URL link. I'm not going to include that one for our example. So now we want to go into creating the form. When somebody submits their information to us, what's that going to look like? Well, let's flip up here and create a new view inside of SmartSuite, and we will use the form view type. So once I hover over here, I get my different options and I find form from the dropdown and I make my selection. Let's create a form view. Now, before moving on, I see that I brought the wrong field over here. I don't want title. So I'm actually going to ditch this. I'm going to remove it And let's bring in the attachments field. This is what I meant to bring into our form. So I've got the contacts, the ticket issue, and then any attachments they might want to include as well. Notice that I can fill out the form title. I can even edit the logo here. And once I'm ready to share my form, all I have to do is copy this link and now share this with whomever I would like to be able to submit tickets into my system. Now I can preview this form, and this is a live version of the form that we just created. And you can see right here, I can go ahead and select myself as a contact. I can write up an issue. Let's say issue number one. I could add an attachment just by dragging it in here or by opening this up and selecting a file from my computer. Once I'm happy with this form, I can submit my ticket, and now we're good to go. Now, if we flip back into our system in tickets, we can see that that was received over here, and now it's up to our team to track it through the process. You can see that we assigned it the default status of backlog, and we don't yet have a priority assigned to it. So if we wanted to go ahead and read over the ticket issue, we look at the attachments internally, and ultimately what we want to do is assign a priority and move it through the status. So is this high, medium, or low? We make that determination, and then as it goes through the process, we can manage that right here. But this isn't really the full picture because we don't know the priority of the different clients, and part of the value in being able to link it to an account and say, hey, this ticket was received on behalf of a certain contact. Well, we want to know what the priority of those different contacts is. So maybe we store something like the lifetime value or monthly revenue that a contact or an opportunity like this brings into our organization. So for example, let's say we're a software service and we have a LTV, like a lifetime value. Well, we can bring that in a currency field type. Let's go ahead and make that selection here, and I'll just rename this to be LTV. And so we could just bring in here the LTV of a client so that we would know on our ticketing system, well, how much of a priority is this? This particular contact, for example, might be worth $1 million a year to us, or $1 million in terms of LTV over the lifespan of this contact. And so, of course, we would want to know that over here, and we could even assign our priorities automatically. In order to do this, the first step would be to look up that value. So I'll use a lookup field. This is going to then allow us to look at our linked relationship to contacts and bring in some other information like the LTV here. So I'll say I'm looking up the LTV. I'm going to go ahead and bring this field in, and we could now imagine an automation that says, hey, if the LTV of a new ticket comes in and it's over $1 million, then automatically assign it to a high priority. Or for example, if an LTV is over $10,000, let's mark that to a low priority. You get the idea. Whatever those rules are, you can set them up. But the final and perhaps most important piece of this entire process would be building automations around the tickets themselves. As they move through various status, and most importantly, as they get to the complete status, we want to notify the person who submitted the ticket in the first place. So lastly, let's go ahead and look up that email address. If we look up the email, we can go ahead and again build a lookup field just like this. Now we're going to bring in that email, and let's go ahead and rename that to lookup email. Add this field, and now I have all the information that I need right here on my ticket, so that when it reaches that complete status, then I can send it to whatever email is getting filled in here. So just like that, we now have that email address in here, and now I can build my automation. So I can simply come in and say, once we have the status inside of our ticket, so when a record matches conditions inside of my tickets application, where the status, and remember it's a status star, is equal to complete, and I can say that I must insist that the lookup email is not empty, otherwise we can't send an email. Well, then I can take an action and I can build an automation that either sends from Gmail, sends from my Outlook email, or sends here from SmartSuite's email, send an email, and we could fill out this information with the information for the ticketing system. So we could say your ticket XYZ has been moved to complete, thank you for submitting it, etc. So this now allows us to stay in contact with our clients all through automation, and we're able to track with our team exactly what's happening inside of our ticketing system as our different contacts and accounts are submitting different bugs, feature requests, etc. I know we went pretty fast in this video, so if you have any questions that I did not cover, be sure to drop those below, and in the meantime, keep on building.